Number of nations are beefing up booster shot rollouts as new variant Omicron spreads further. Meanwhile, world health officials are warning the world needs to work as one to end the pandemic. Here's Australia correspondent Andrew McFarlane.
It didn't even have a name a week ago, but now there's only one word on the lips of health officials.
Omicron.
From Spain to Sydney, the further the strain spreads, the louder the alarm grows. With the head of the World Health Organization warning nations need to work together and prioritise vaccinating developing countries.
Indeed, our ability to end this pandemic is a test of our collective ability to prevent, respond effectively to future pandemics, because the same principles apply.
Some are listening. China's now pledging 1 billion doses to Africa, where immunisation rates are comparatively low. We must continue to fight together against COVID, says Mr. Xi, adding he'll send around 1,500 medical workers to Africa. And today, the US president thanked South Africa for sounding the alarm so early.
This kind of transparency is to be encouraged and applauded because it increases our ability to respond quickly to any new threats.
But while there are indications Omicron's more infectious than Delta, it's too early to know if it's more deadly. So, while developing nations struggle to get shots in arms, richer ones like Britain are charging ahead with third jabs or boosters.
If vaccine effectiveness is reduced, as seems pretty likely to some extent, the biggest effects are likely to be in preventing infections, and hopefully there will be smaller effects on preventing severe disease.
Australia's government was heavily criticised for acting too slow against Delta, so now it's looking at offering booster jabs before the regular 6 months after people get their second jab.
That whilst it's an emerging variant, it's manageable.
New Zealand's open to the idea too.
If our advisory groups say to us, look, we think we should shorten that time, we are able to do that, but we always listen to the evidence and advice.
That advice could be some way off. Scientists say it could take 3 weeks before we know just how dangerous Omicron is. Andrew McFarlane, One News, Sydney.